Hello everybody, welcome back. This will be my empties for January 2017. I have a wide array of things, candles, skincare, some hair care. So I finished a shampoo. This is from Generic Value Products. It's the Tea Tree Oil Shampoo. It is comparable to the Paul Mitchell Tea Tree Special Shampoo. I got this from Sally's. It's a liter. It is a drying shampoo to my hair when I was using it as the only shampoo. And I had stopped using it for a while because I didn't enjoy the fact that it was drying out my hair. But I use it now as, well, that's how I finished it up, as a clarifying shampoo. So it was my first shampoo. And then I had a moisturizing shampoo, and then I had my dandruff shampoo. I don't know that I would buy this again, and I don't know that I would buy it in the liter, because it just took so long for me to use. But it was not a bad product, but it is drying, so you would have to pay attention to that. From Colgate, it is the Total Advanced Pro Shield Peppermint Blast Anti-Gingivitis and Anti-Plaque Mouthwash. It was blue. I enjoyed it. It didn't burn at all when I used it. It is alcohol-free, but I have some mouthwashes that I've used that were alcohol-free. They still left a burning, tingling type of sensation, but I really did enjoy this. I wouldn't mind buying this one in the future. And then a big body wash. This is from Dove. It is the Go Fresh Revive Body Wash with Nutrium Moisture and Pomegranate and Lemon Verbena scent. I enjoyed the scent. I just do not enjoy Dove body wash. I don't know if it's this Nutrium Moisture one. Because I remember when Dove first came out with their body washes, because they used to just be bar soap. And I really enjoyed it. This smells really great, but it didn't lather like I wanted it to. It was a really thick consistency. I just did not enjoy this, and I would not repurchase this. This is the Crest 3D White Daily Cleansing and Whitening System. It was a two-step process. This is what the toothpaste looked like. It was the step one. It was a deep cleansing toothpaste. I did enjoy it. And then step two was a white tube, and it had the whitening gel in it. I still have some of the whitening gel left. That's why it's not in here. I did enjoy this. I could be up to repurchasing this in the future, but I just got so tired of the two-step system. Because you brush your teeth with step one for a minute, spit it out, but you do not rinse, and then you apply the whitening gel to your toothbrush, brush your teeth for a minute, spit and rinse. Sometimes I just got so tired of the two-step system. But it was a good product. I felt it whitened my teeth really nicely, and my teeth were never sensitive. So I am definitely up to purchasing it again. But for now, I'm going to go to the one-step toothpaste, you know? Completely Bare Facial Hair Removal Cream. I hated this product from the moment I got it. This is what it looks like. It has a little plastic piece, and you twist it around, and then you don't have to touch the cream, which is great in the concept, which is really great. But there's still product in here, but it dried up, and I tried to put a pin in there to remove the blockage, but it did not help. But I didn't like this when I first started using it. I got this at Ulta. It didn't remove the hair. You know, I use it upper lip, and this, I would prefer my Sally Hansen that I have to this, because this didn't remove the hair, and I left it on for, yeah, you don't leave it on for more than 10 minutes. I left it on for 8 minutes like I do the Sally Hansen. And it didn't remove a lot, and so you were still left there, and you're like, bruh. So I would not buy this again. This is the cinnamon bun candle. This came from Dollar Tree. This one actually smelt like a little bakery. You can smell the cinnamon completely. I really enjoyed this product. I really like this candle. It was a really great scent. Then there was blueberry pie. It's a fake blueberry scent, and it's not a great fake blueberry scent, so I wouldn't buy this one again. I think I got these for Christmas. Both of these for Christmas, so. I enjoy burning candles, so it really didn't matter. This is the Pure Radiance by Yankee Candle in Crackling Winter. It crackled, which was its claim to fame. The scent, Crackling Winter, you either smelt nothing or you smelled a little soap. Everything smells like soap. But this is like ivory soap. You know, it was just that clean soap scent. And that's what it smelled like. And sometimes you smelt it, sometimes you didn't. I wouldn't purchase the Crackling Winter scent again. I don't know that I would even purchase a Pure Radiance candle. I did enjoy the crackling, and the glass looks like it's wood. I don't know if you can see that, but I was underwhelmed by the whole concept here. Let's see, this is from Yankee Candle. I got it for Christmas. It's the Alpine Martini. I burnt a lot of candles this month. Ugh. Okay. This wasn't a great scent. To smell it before you burnt it, you could smell like a little cranberry. It had, you know, like a fir. Yeah, fir tree. You know, Douglas or whatever. Because you're in the Alpine, so it's going to be mountainy. And it's a martini, so once you burned it, all you got was this weird alcohol scent. Like, you just smelled alcohol and it had like a hint of sweet on it. I did not enjoy that at all. And it was too overpowering, that word, for my bedroom. So I had to move it out to the kitchen. But I would not get this scent. That was not great. This one I actually enjoyed. This was the Candy Cane Meringue. It was peppermint. It's got sweetness to it. Because it's meringue is, what is it, sugar and egg whites or something? I don't know, but just really great scent. I really love peppermint and mint scents to begin with. And I love when they're mixed with a hint of sweetness. This was a really great scent. I do wish their candles would burn a little better, but. Then I have two of these Etamins. They came from the dollar store. I got them for Christmas. All butter loaf cake and the lemon pound cake. I didn't get a scent payoff from either one of them. I can smell lemon in this box right now, but I didn't get any payoff. And this just smells like old butter. Then I also got these for Christmas. They came from the Dollar Tree. The Starburst Blueberry. It was the fake blueberry, but you actually smelt it. And it's like that candy blueberry, like a Starburst would be. And then the Melon Berry Skittles, no scent payoff whatsoever. Okay, and my last candle is from Bath & Body Works. It is the Twisted Peppermint. And like I said, I love peppermint. It smells so good. It's peppermint. Let's see, it's says, Merry and Bright Peppermint celebrates the season with notes of vanilla and sugary musk in this cheer-filled scent. I love this scent. I would buy it over and over again. It reminds me of like a little bit of burnt sugar. I love that. And the mint was great with it. Superb. Okay, that was 10 candles in jars. And then number 11 is a votive from Yankee Candle and Bakery Air. It was just sugar and cinnamon and just good sweet smells. And it actually had a really nice payoff. All right, we are done with candles now. Yes, all done with candles. From Sally's, this is the Heel to Toe Spa Pedicure Collection. Feels like new foot softener. I've had a couple of these before in my empties. This one is completely done. It's a yellow, goldeny yellowish color, and it's balm in texture. And it has a, well, I enjoy the scent. It's got like tea tree or maybe some eucalyptus in it. And it does soften your heels, but you do need to be careful because they will be slick until it completely absorbs. So your best bet is to put it on before bed and put some socks on. Go to sleep. I would be up to repurchasing this again. I finished two of the Hask Super Strength Henna and Placenta Conditioning Treatment packets. I like Hask. I love Hask. I enjoyed these. I use them on two separate occasions. But I prefer the olive oil, the green ones, because it just gives me a little more moisture to my hair, which I enjoy. But there's nothing bad about these. This is also from Hask. It is the Placenta Original Leave-In Instant Conditioning Treatment. I have a few more of these left. I really do like this for when I don't do a deep conditioner in the shower. Okay, this is Simply Shea with Organic Shea Butter Deep Conditioner and Co-Wash. I got this from the dollar store, Dollar Tree. It had a really nice scent. It was a really thick conditioner. I want to say I got two, maybe three, I think about three uses out of this. I don't know that I would buy it again, just that it's so little, but if I was in the market just to have a deep conditioner, co-wash type of situation, I would definitely buy this. And it's 6 ounces. From Neutrogena, the Norwegian Formula Hand Cream and Original. When I was a kid, the commercials were for Swedish fishermen. And how, because this is so concentrated that only a small amount leaves dry, cracked hands noticeably softer and smoother after just one application. It is a very thick consistency. It's like a really thick petroleum jelly to me. I enjoyed it. I don't know that I would buy it. I could see if you spend a lot of time out in the cold or in the water that this could be helpful to you. Okay, I finished a little mini of the Body Source Nutritives Powered by Nature White Tea Body Bi-Tender Protective Moisture Lotion. This came in a little set from Kohl's during Christmas. I didn't enjoy the scent. It was moisturizing, but I hated the scent. It was off and weird. I didn't like it. From Bath & Body Works, this is a fun size body lotion in Deep Aqua. I like the scent. I know they don't make it anymore. But it was just a really nice light fragrance. It wasn't overpowering. It was just a really nice light fragrance. I would buy the scent again, but they don't make it. From It's a 10, the Miracle Leave-In Plus Keratin. This is the 4 ounce. I got this from Ulta. It was like a gift with purchase. God have mercy. I enjoyed it for my hair. I don't know that I would buy the It's a 10 line. Because I don't know that it does anything spectacular for my hair for me to purchase something of that price. When I find other things that I really enjoy that are more reasonably priced. From Bath & Body Works, the Sparkling Hair Resling Deep Cleansing Hand Soap. I love the scent of this. I would buy this scent again. The wine scents were really, really good. I enjoyed them. Village Naturals Therapy Aches and Pains Muscle Relief Concentrated Mineral Bath Soap, Eucalyptus, Spearmint, and Menthol. I got two uses out of this. This came in a Walmart beauty box. I used these in a foot bath to soak my feet, and I really enjoyed it that way. I don't know that I would buy this particular one for a foot bath when you can just buy Epsom salts from like the dollar store or whatever and add your own essential oils if you chose. But if to put into a bath, I think this would be really nice. I really enjoyed the scent, and it turned the water like a little blue, or not blue, a little green. I like that. Finished the Wonder Puffs. Finish that. I get four deep cleansing puffs for $1.50 from Five Below. I know they also sell them at Christmas Tree. And I've seen them like at the drugstore. But this is what they look like. I really enjoy them. They're nice for my face. They're not overly harsh. I just add a little of my cleanser to them and go to work. I finished two cleansing cloths, one from Simple. This was just a little 7-pack. I actually didn't mind these, but I don't think I would buy them. It did have a really nice towel to it. Yep, the towel was really nice to it. But they weren't as moist as I would like them to be. The Wet n Wild Under the Sheets. This was 10. I got these from Dollar Tree. They were really nice. I could see myself buying them in the future because they are a reasonably priced towel. I would look into buying the bigger size that they sell at the drugstore, but it was nice to try 10 of them for $1 at the dollar store. I did 3 sheet masks this month. A blueberry face mask from the cream shop. This had hyaluronic acid in it. I didn't enjoy the scent. It was blueberry. What is up with all this blueberry that it doesn't smell right to me? It was off-putting, but my face was really nice and soft. And I like that this one had, it was oddly shaped too. Like I had more of the sheet to come on this side of my face. Like, and we could have used more at the top here. And I like that it has those little flaps on the inside. I want to say the Cooling Cucumber one had it too, where you could do your under eye at the same time, because usually the mask, they don't touch there properly. But I was told not to complain because it cost a dollar. But I didn't like the scent, so I'm not going to buy this one again. The cooling Cucumber by Nature. All 3 of these masks I got from Shop Miss A. I did enjoy this one. This one was nice and cooling. And it had the little extra fold to go underneath your eye. I really enjoyed that. I would definitely buy this one again. And then the Q10 and Pomegranate Age Defying and Hydrating Facial Mask by Malibu Glitz. I really like this one too. My face always feels hydrated with them, but I don't see how your face wouldn't feel or look hydrated using a face mask. And I leave my face mask on until they dry completely, and then you just take it off. I want to get the full benefit of it. And I would buy that pomegranate one again. Finished a sample of the Glam Glow Super Mud Clearing Treatment. I really like this. I would buy it again. This one it does dry, you know. And once it's dry, you do need to take it off. I think it just, if your face doesn't have enough to clear, I think it just starts to suck out moisture instead of sebum that you're looking for to clear. But I did enjoy this. I would look into purchasing the full size in the future. I finished 4 perfume samples. Let's see. Pink Flower by Pink Sugar. I would buy that one. Michael Kors Wonderlust. This is the second Michael Kors fragrance I have ever enjoyed. I don't know that I would buy it, but I actually enjoyed it. The other one I enjoy is their Amber something or other. See, Elizabeth and James Nirvana Bourbon. I was actually surprised that this one wasn't horrible to me. Because I don't really like the Elizabeth and James. I don't like the black. I don't like the white. And I think I've smelled the rose. Because I know they're supposed to be complementary scents that you're supposed to use together. But I didn't like the black and white enough on their own or together to say, yeah, let's buy that. And I really wanted to because it's Mary-Kate and Ashley. But I actually enjoyed the bourbon. And I know I don't like the rose. So I'm not going to buy the scent. And then this one, oh, I have never smelled Yves Saint Laurent's Black Opium before. Oh my God, this is amazing. So this is definitely on the list to buy. Oh, it smells so good. Yes ma'am. See, I did a hot oil treatment. Get these 2 for $1 from the dollar store. This is the NUX Creme Fraiche Debut Mask. It's a soothing and rehydrating fresh mask. The first time I used it, I didn't realize it was a moisturizer type of situation where you would put on a layer of it and what didn't absorb you would rub in. I put it on like you would, like a charcoal or a clay mask that you rinse off. That's how I used it the first time, but then the second time I did it like I was supposed to and I broke out a little bit, so I'm glad to have tried it, but I would not purchase it. The Curel Hydrotherapy Wet Skin Moisturizer. This is my second sample of it. I actually really like this. This is very comparable to the Jergens Wet Skin, where you shower, apply this, and then you towel dry. You go about your day, and I was moisturized all day, 24 hours with this. I would purchase this in the future. From Manicadar, it is the Sheer Glow Shimmer Lotion. Got this through Ipsy. I didn't notice anything when I applied it to my face directly, so I was just mixing it with foundation, and I really liked that it was thinning out the foundation. But I don't know that I would buy it just to thin out foundation. Then from Aveda, it's the Damage Remedy Daily Hair Repair with Quinoa Protein. It was nice. It smelled good. I don't know that I would buy it, but it was nice to try. From Avon Clear Skin Blackhead Eliminating Deep Treatment Mask. It was a mask that went from blue to white when it was done. I enjoyed it. It did help, you know, just control oil because it has salicylic acid in it. So, I have another one of these in my collection, so. The Ulta Hydra Quench Foaming Oil Cleanser in Renew. I didn't enjoy this at all. I didn't like it. You apply it to wet skin. You gently massage to activate the lather. I wasn't a fan of it. I finished it up in the shower. I would wash my hands before applying masks or scrubs to my face. That's how I finished this up because I didn't enjoy it. My face never felt clean. It just felt like a little like grease slick or something. I don't know. It was weird. I didn't like it. The Fresh Soy Face Cleanser. I actually really like this. I would put this on the list to buy because usually my face does not enjoy natural products. They start to break out, but this one was really, really nice. I I don't know if the amino acids helped. I don't know what it was, but this was really nice. I would look into purchasing the soy face cleanser in the future. From Symphony Beauty, it's the Snow Cream Moisturizer. Got this through Ipsy. It had like a bouncy texture to it. Had a little one a long way. Otherwise, it would just start to ball up and roll off your face. It was weird. I'm not gonna buy that, but I enjoyed using it. Then I finished another Glam Glow. This one I actually bought. This is the Youth Mud Tingle Exfoliate Treatment. I like this one too. It was a, well, they're both dry on your face, but I want to say this one had more of the little like seaweed pieces or something in it. I would look into buying the full size. If you want to try these, I know they sell like them. These are $19 or $22 or something. Try to get one of these little plastic tube samples. You can get 2-3 uses out of one of these. And I know I get these through subscriptions. My Ipsy, Sephora, I even want to say maybe Birchbox gave me one. I don't know, but I don't think it's worth it to try it for $19 in this little container. I don't know, maybe try to get a sample when you go to Sephora. Maybe they can help you that way. Then I finished 2 Peter Thomas Roth little samples. I have another one. It's the 24 karat gold one. I got them in a 3-pack for $25 from Sephora. The Irish More Mud. It's the purifying black mask. And this one was the cucumber gel mask. It was a extreme detoxifying hydrator. I wasn't impressed with the cucumber one. I didn't feel that it did anything great. It didn't feel like it was hydrating. I didn't feel like I was detoxifying anything. It was just like you slathered gel on your face. I wouldn't buy the full size of that. The Irish Moor, I'm on the fence because you apply it to your face and you do not get to go back over. If you missed a spot or it's patchy, you do not get to go back over to fill in the patchiness or it will pick up the rest, which was weird to me. I do think it helped, you know, purify, you know, control any oil or sebum. So that was great. But I'm still on the fence about the Irish Moor Mud. We are almost done, people. Almost done. Alright, I finished 2 hand sanitizers. They're both from Bath & Body Works. This is a pocket back in American Berry Pie. This scent wasn't great. I smelled the berry scent twice. And the rest of the time it was just like straight alcohol. So it was not a great scent. Now you smell the berry. Get out of here. Get out. This one, I really love the scent. You just smell like bananas. I love that. This was from their Just for Kids line. It's the antibacterial instant hand foam Bananarama Ding Dong. It was a foaming hand soap. I have a hand sanitizer. I have a couple more of them. I really like this. It smelled like bananas. It was just a really nice product. I finished a nail polish from Sally Hansen. It is the nail color. It was just a clear. I used it as a top coat. I'm glad to get rid of a top coat. I own tons of them. I finished 2 lip balms. This is from Avon, the Care Deeply lip balm with aloe. I actually enjoyed it. You usually get these like 99 cents at the holiday time. I don't know how much they cost regular. But I would buy it for indoors because it was actually a really nice lip balm. Then the ChapStick Total Hydration Moisture Intent in Coral Blush. Got this one in a Target box. This was when they were exclusive to Target. Now I think everybody is selling the Moisture Intent ones. I was trying to get you guys a swatch of it. It was just too orange on my lips. If I was to buy, which I am not opposed to, I would look and do a different color for me. Because it looks really pretty in tube. You know, it doesn't look like it would be anything but like a nice little red. But it was orange on my lips. It was much too orange. And I didn't enjoy that coral of it. I would have enjoyed a corally pink. Not a orangey coral. Alright you guys, that was the end of my haul. I had a ton of things that I finished in January. Very proud to have cleaned them out of my life. Find some things I enjoy. Use up some things I enjoy. Find some things that I did not enjoy. And it was nice to have a sample of it and let it go. I want to thank you guys for viewing. Next month there are going to be tons of foil packets. FYI. I want to thank you guys for viewing. If you enjoyed, please hit that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please do. I would love to have you. And if you've already subscribed, thank you very much. I want you guys to be safe, be well, peace.